what can we learn from CrossFit? Now, CrossFit's one of those things, and I'm in the exercise science field. I notice that either people hate it or they love it, okay? And it's very, in fact, you know what's really interesting? Like, the National Strength Conditioning Association, like I actually used to be an associate editor on the journal, National Strength Conditioning Association Journal. And basically, National Strength Conditioning Association attacked CrossFit because they thought that the movement patterns under high volumes could cause things like injury. And then CrossFit countered and sued back. You have literally the largest strength conditioning organization in CrossFit suing back, and it's still going on today. Really interesting, right? You have people who make fun of CrossFitters, and then you have a culture of people in CrossFit that's growing every single day. Like, you can't, whether you like it or don't like it, you can't ignore the growth of it. And as the growth has increased, it's being featured on national television is increasing more and more and more. And different television shows are spinning off from CrossFit. Whether they're CrossFit or not, they're being spun from the genesis of CrossFit. Now, one of the things that I notice, and being a muscle PhD, it's really my job to notice this, is when you look at national competitions, it's really cool what they do. But these people are jacked. And they're not just jacked, they're shredded. And they're not just shredded, they're vascular, right? So let's take a step back, and whether you like CrossFit or you don't like CrossFit, right? These people are jacked and they're shredded and they're vascular, and probably there's something that we can learn from them. So what are the principles we can peel from them, okay? Well, number one thing I want to talk about with CrossFit is you got to look at the structure of the workout, right? I was just talking to Jack. He's filming this right now. Jack's into CrossFit. Jack's actually shredded and he's vascular, okay? So when you look at actually the workouts that they do, number one, when you go into the gym, there's a new challenge every single day. In fact, you might not even know what awaits you in a competition. You walk in there, it's on the board, and you got to go get it, okay? Same thing when you're going to a CrossFit gym. You walk in there, it's on the board, you got to go get it. What do we talk about? That is variation, okay? Unlike the guy or the bro who walks in and every time they do a chest day, they're just going to start off with doing 5-10 sets of bench press. You don't know what's going to hit you on a day of CrossFit. That's variation, which is in line with the principle of accommodation. Remember, if you do the same thing every single time, you'll stop growing. They always are doing a new challenge, okay? Remember, what's important for variation? New exercises. They're always doing something different. That keeps the body growing. That's number one, okay? Number two, if you look at their workouts, they might start off with a strength day, and they're doing maximal lifts, sets of 3, for example. Could be sets of 5, for example. That's heavy lifting. One of the main ways that you grow is that heavy stimulus. That's causing a lot of muscle damage. But then the rest of their workout is conditioning based, and it's goal based. They might do a set of circuits, and they're trying to get as many repetitions as they can on that circuit, which could change every single day, okay? When you measure the blood of CrossFitters during those circuits, their blood lactate levels reach as high as I've ever seen in the literature. Sometimes you might see 15, 16 millimoles of lactate in their blood. And by the way, lactate threshold is like 4 millimoles. They're sitting at 4 times the amount of the time when it's hard to even breathe, and they're still going. So what we know is that if you take muscle cells in the lab and you expose them to lactate, they grow in isolation. So they're being bathed in this anabolic, acidic environment that makes you grow. Okay, what else can we learn from CrossFitters? Their cardiovascular conditioning is insane. They're essentially concurrent training, but their type of cardio is giant set, superset circuits. So in essence, it's interval type training. Look at sprinters, some of the leanest athletes in the world. In fact, we did a study, and we talked about this earlier, where we found the higher the intensity of cardio, the more shredded you become and the less muscle that you actually lose during a cut. So basically, they're combining this metabolic training, this cardio that's interval style. They have heavy lifting. They're hitting repetitions at all different zones, and they switch it up every single day. Now, whether you're a CrossFitter or not, using those principles are going to get you shredded, lean, huge, and vascular. So I'll definitely study what they do and at least apply some of the principles to your training. You might just grow. Thank you so much, guys. I'll see you next time.